The Centenary Club Lifeline, supporting Dunfermline Athletic Football Club. Join today.
Right, lads, thanks for joining us. First of all, what's your feelings about being back at East End, bringing back some good memories from the season that we're talking about today?
Yeah, I was just saying in the drive-ups, it's kind of first time I've been back in years, so yeah, it brings back memories, and especially seeing all the games in there. And you had to look at the fixture list to jog my memory of what the results were, some of the games, but yeah, it's good to be back.
How about you, Kevin?
I mean, I've been at a few games since, you know, just doing bits and pieces. But it's great to come back and look at some of the old footage, you know, that year, and obviously more the second half of the season for myself, but it's really good. It's really good to revisit that.
We'll focus on the second half of the season, because that's when that's when everything started to take shape. What were your feelings, first of all, coming in January, the sort of end of January, Kevin? Were you pleased to be joining a club like Dunfermline who are challenging for a title?
Yeah, it was, you know, I've said before, like the time Falkirk were in, you know, and basically I had to sit down and decide who I wanted to join and who I thought was going to win the league, who was better placed to go on and win the league, you know, and having looked at both squads and, you know, everything, spoke to both managers, I just get a feeling, you know, and sometimes your gut's wrong, sometimes it's right, but as soon as I came in here, I knew after, you know, two or three games, I knew that we were had a right good chance of winning this league, and that's what materialised, you know.
And you'd obviously been here for, I think it was your third season, you were saying.
Yeah.
And was there a feeling amongst the squad that this was going to be here? Because it was kind of nip and tuck with Raith Rovers. They had their noses in front for quite a lot of the season and kept on picking up late goals and late draws and all the rest. And it wasn't until the final wee bit that people cleared. But there was always a feeling within the squad that we could win the league that year.
Yeah, as I said, it kind of took Mac a few years to get rid of a lot of kind of high wage earners, and eventually this was his team. It's just that he moulded it the way he wanted to play. And as you say, we were kind of nip and tuck with Raith Rovers throughout the season. But I say the big point, the turning point, was when we kind of brought Kevin, Martin Hardy in, brought Liam Buchanan in just in January, February, and that gave us that wee edge. I think that proved vital in the running.
Besides the Raith Rovers game, which we'll get to in a second, probably the other vital game that's been picked out is the Ross County game, midweek, last minute winner. But like Martin, he was saying that it was really when, you know, that was the crunch time really, and it was a massive, massive win.
Yeah, especially getting a last minute winner. It kind of, I mean, you're fighting, and just to get a last minute winner, but it kind of just lifted the confidence a wee bit more, and it kind of gave us that belief, and I say that kicked us on, and I say proved vital in towards the end of the season.
And how much of a boost was it having Kevin in just to shore up that defence?
Again, it was vital. I see him and Martin had came for St Johnstone where they'd previously won the title, so they knew what it took to win the title. And then I said, kind of gave that experience. We had a lot of young boys in the team who'd never been in that position before, so to get the turn at that stage of the season was great for us.
Moving on to the Raith Rovers game, Kevin, I believe you missed the game through injury.
No, I got sent off.
You got sent off the week before,
Tom? Jasper's fault.
What happened with the send off?
So I remember it.
Can I just go back to Ross County game?
Of course.
You know, because that winner, actually, I'm taking credit for that, because Martin was actually trying to hit a free kick, believe it or not, for the corner of the field, like in the corner, up at Ross County in the 89th minute.
So he did.
6'3", he wanted to hit a shot, and I was screaming, you know, get in the box, you big numpty, or something like that. And lo and behold, he goes and scores it, and he'll say, I'll go where I want, kind of. I don't even remember that.
I can
celebration. I'll do what I want. that's a game actually that does stick out in my mind as well, Ross County game. But the Queen of the South game, actually, what happened, we get counter attacked, and I get left a wee bit. I was open, you know, I get a wee bit exposed with the team. I think we're getting carried away, we get gung ho. And it ends up, the ball gets played in behind, and somebody's come in for the blind side, and I took him down. It was big Derek Holmes, big striker. And I get sent off, but it really affected the side because we went 1-6-1 that day. So it was 10 men, you know what I mean? But at that point, that typified as a team where we were. You know, and at that point, there was a feeling nothing was going to stop us, whether it be losing a player to injury, or suspension, or if it was a referee, maybe not getting a lot in that particular day, whoever it was against, you know, but it was a real feeling. There's nothing going to stop us now because we could smell it. You know what I mean? We're approaching the business end of the season. We could smell as a medal to everyone. Do you know what I mean? And for me, I mean, I was gutted to be missing it. I remember, I think I went in a right rant after it, you know, cursing and whatever about missing the eighth game, because that boiled into that game, you know, for the season. And but I had no fears that we were going to go and do the business again, so I was just gutted to be missing it. But nah, the boys were, I knew we were going to win it.
So you were obviously in the stand along with 11,500 other people. What was it like playing in front of the, you know, that size of the crowd, seeing you stand packed to the rafters?
It was unbelievable, especially coming out of the tunnel, just seeing the whole back end of the stand full. And it did inspire us, even though we were 1-0 down at half time. We weren't dejected in the dressing room, because we felt we'd played that well, and the manager thought that as well, and he just kept telling us to keep going, do what we're doing. And as you say, Wigman produced the goods on the day, but Kevin says it was a vital one, a vital, vital, vital game. And we went down to Morton the next week, and we were speaking about it earlier.
Yeah.
There was no way we were losing that game, no way.
No.
We could have went there, because we had a couple of injury problems on the day as well. A couple of boys missed a game, Wigman, Martin missed a game, mm-hmm. Alec Buck missed a game, but I said we had a squad that had that belief, so whatever the guys came in, we went down there and we won the game, and said the rest is history.
It was a great day down at Greenock, and you as captain as well the following week against Falkirk. That was another great occasion, another big crowd, and you were the guy to lift the trophy.
Yeah, I'd say proud to be a captain. But I say the team we had, we had various leaders through the team, but on the day, when we were lining up to get the trophy, it was a proud moment for myself, and something I'll cherish. See, I've still got photographs and that in the house, courtesy of Craig. So it's something I look back on.
And finally, both of you have been back here today and seen some of the old footage and seen familiar faces. It must be good to see the guys again.
Yeah, it is.
Murder.
Yeah, it's good to catch up with people. But I was sitting at Martin on the drive through, so I can't believe it's been and gone. My football career's gone. Time passes like that. But yeah, it's something I've enjoyed. And I say that's. My spell at Dunfermline was by far the best throughout my career. I enjoyed it thoroughly, and I say it's good to be back.
Cherish that. Squads, you know, when you slow down, you don't move as quick and play anywhere, you cherish the big moments in your career. So for some people, we're lucky enough that we've got a championship, you know, but for some people it's one game, you know, but we can reflect on half a season for myself, full season for Ozzy being captain, just a tremendous achievement, you know, and you can go and cherish, and some boys you didn't go with me, but some boys you did, but that's all part, you know, we just had to make up a right good squad and a really good team. And as I say, I'm proud to be part of it, so it's top notch quality.